The Georgetown Wet Weather Treatment Station is being built right in the heart of Georgetown. This treatment station will collect and clean up to 70 million gallons per day of wastewater and stormwater that would have spilled into the Duwamish River in heavy rains. King County wanted construction to be just as sustainable as the new facility will be. The first step in a large construction project may be removing what's already on site, which could include existing buildings, contaminated soils, or other materials, and preparing the site for construction of our facility.
King County has memorialized our commitment to green or sustainable building. This commitment continues all the way from planning through construction to operations and maintenance. Within the wastewater treatment division, the whole project team contributes ideas to what we refer to as a sustainable scorecard. This scorecard helps us to track activities and progress towards our goals. In addition, the county strategic climate action plan has targets for zero waste of resources with economic value by the year 2030. For this project, we set a goal of an 85% diversion rate. So we wanted to divert 85% of the waste from construction and demolition from landfill disposal.
We look for ways to recycle and reuse materials, and we track what we're diverting to see how it best meets our goals. On the Georgetown project site, we needed to tear down 5 buildings and remove concrete surfaces and underground equipment. The buildings and concrete allowed us opportunities to recycle, but also presented some challenges with lead-painted surfaces and contaminated soils from past activities.
On this project, we're doing the demolition remediation phase. They call it the site prep phase. So we demolished 5 buildings. We removed about 7,000 tons of contaminated soil. And when we're all done, we will be capping the site with 4 inches of erosion control rock. We've been in business for a little over 10 years. Demolition remediation has always been part of our business model. The diversion goals have definitely gotten a lot loftier in years. Some of them have been easily achievable depending on the composition of the project, and some have been a lot more challenging to achieve. Project, we were able to achieve upwards of 90%. A lot of that came from salvage of old growth timbers. Old growth timbers are something that just aren't made anymore, so it's a rare commodity, and there's only so much of it to go around. Some things that can typically be reused on site is the concrete you can crush on site and use as recycled aggregate. What was clean was hauled off site to be recycled, and then recycled concrete was brought in for backfill.
Sustainable building is not just saving costs, but it's also looking at our impact to the community and trying to minimize that.
With the types of materials on site, we needed to keep water runoff and dust under control.
Environmental regulations are going to continue to become more stringent, especially in terms of air quality and surface water impacts. So the biggest thing is water. You got to keep everything wet, keep everything from getting airborne in the first place. This job in particular, we had great success with keeping everything wet. We had a very dry summer, so dust control was challenging all the way around. But we were real successful in using our engineering controls to limit any impact to the community.
Our contractors worked very hard and was very successful maintaining these controls during demolition.
You know, I think this project, King County did an above average job at the pre-planning phase and also planning for community impacts. They have a whole team dedicated to community outreach. And I think that pre-planning speaks for itself. This is a very successful project.
Sustainable building helps lower our long-term operations and maintenance costs, which results in savings to our ratepayers. King County's green building ordinance ensures that we're working toward our goals.